Hello everybody and welcome back to my channel Harubo Hobby Gaming. And in this episode of If I Goes, I'm gonna review one of, I think, one of the best Touch 7 Destroyer Assault online. And this is the Tower Assault. Yes, this is the Assault series of Destroyer, and there is 4 ship on Destroyer Assault, which is the Dragon Assault, Tower Assault, Korak Assault, and the last is, wait, I forgot. August Assault. And let's take a look what they are. Yes, this is it. This is the Korak Assault. This is the Tower Assault. This is the Dragon Assault. And this is the August Assault. And if we take a look at their bonus for Assault series, there always be plus 5 second damage control activation time. So it can tank a little bit longer than any of the other destroyer ship can. But yes, let's take a look at their bonuses. For Korak Assault, we got roll bonus about plus 25% missile or torpedo velocity, plus 5 second damage control activation time, and for this advanced small missile or torpedo operation, we got plus 37.5% small missile torpedo damage and plus 50% small missile or torpedo explosion velocity. And yes, the missile on Korak Assault is the best, I think. This is can attack anything at full damage. And this is it. Advanced Destroyer Command bonus, we get plus 7.5% per level to stasis will be fire optimal range, which is nice. This is why Destroyer Assault is good, because any of them have electronic warfare advantage. And for this Korak Assault, we have plus 7.5% stasis will be fire optimal range per level and plus 7.5% energy Nosferatu optimal range per level. So we got about plus 37.5% upgrade to optimal range, which is very very good for tackling or maybe PvE. Yes, so I think we can get optimal range about 20 kilometers, which is very very nice to attack any frigates or any other destroyer who have small turret, because small turret is not reaching 20 kilometers. Okay, for the next was this, we got Tower Assault, and let's discuss that later. Let's move that to Dragon Assault. For Dragon Assault, this is drone specialized. We got plus 12.5% drone velocity, plus 5 second damage control activation time, which is the same. And for advanced small drone operation, we got plus 30% drone DPS. So we can upgrade this to plus 150% drone DPS, which is nice. And plus 5% drop velocity. And the next was advanced destroyer command bonus. Nah, for advanced destroyer command bonus, this Dragon Assault got plus 7.5% energy Nosferatu optimal range and plus 7.5% energy neutralizer optimal range. I don't think the Dragon Assault is good, because energy Nosferatu on Dragon is, you can see the oh, I see. So the Dragon Assault, I think, can use medium neutralizer and medium Nosferatu. And if we look at the capacitor on Tower Assault, look at that. Oh, it's the same. Oh, sorry, sorry. The power grid, I think. The power grid. Yes. For Destroyer Assault, the Destroyer is very underrated for their power grid, and they can use medium models like this Dragon Assault. I think if we use medium energy Nosferatu, it will be stacked on their power grid. And of course, it's not good because the small energy Nosferatu is not good enough because the smell about the range is very, very small too, or very short. Okay, next for the Algos Assault. For the Algos Assault, we got same like, yes, that's Dragon Assault, but the Advanced Destroyer Command bonus is different. The first difference is plus 7.5% Warp Disruptor Optimal Range. Yes, this is very good actually for tackling, but the second one is plus 7.5% Energy Neutralizer Optimal Range. And once again, that's not good if you are solo. Okay, for the last and we are using today is this Tower Assault. For the roll bonus, we got plus 25% missile or torpedo velocity, plus 5 second damage control activation time. For advanced small missile or torpedo operation, we got plus 7.5% small missile or torpedo damage. Nah, this is good. This is the best from all of them, I think. Advanced destroyer command bonus, we got minus 15% warp drive signature radius penalty. What is that? We are gonna explain that on fitting explanation. And this is it, plus 7.5% stasis wavy fire optimal range, which is very nice. Okay, now let's move for the fitting explanation. Minmatar Talwar Assault. For the high slot, we got PC type small missile launcher, which is very nice with DPS about 75.5%. And I think for destroyer, we got offense DPS about 302 is very nice. And yes, the middle slot is of course the stasis wavy fire, predator stasis wavy fire. And look at that optimal range. The normal optimal range after skill is 15 km, and after this bonus we got optimal range about 20.35 km, which is very, very nice. And if you look at the advanced destroyer command, we got minus 15% warp drive signature radius penalty. And what is that? This is it. We got KISTC type small micro warp drive. Now, if you look at the signature radius adjustment, this show 103%. But what is the normal signature radius adjustment? Let's take a look at this slot. Micro warp drive. Nah, look at that. This is the same. Nah, KISTC type small micro warp drive, and you can look at that. Signature radius adjustment is 413%. This is very big, and look at that turbo assault, just only 103%. And which make the tower assault is, yes, just a little small. I mean, if we use the micro drive, of course we got faster, but the signature is going up highly, so we are easily being hit by the enemies. But if we use that on tower assault and our signature radius goes down to 103%, of course we don't need to worry that about that. Yes, so this is the nice point on this tower assault. And of course that web is very nice too. And the next was the Sandy C type small shield booster, Pit C type adaptive invulnerability field, and the last was this all around damage. You can look at that activation time is 18 seconds. The base is 13 seconds. This is plus 5 seconds from the tower assault or destroyer assault roll bonus. Okay, now for the combat board, combat tricks, we got usual warhead calefaction catalyst tree, payloading accelerator, and this is hydraulic pay thruster. And for the navigation rig, we got auxiliary thruster tree for flight velocity adjustment, polycarbon engine housing for inertia modifier, and of course we need this dynamic fuel valve tree. Enable capacitor need adjustment minus 40%. So we don't need to use any, sorry, we don't use any much our capacitor for micro warp drive. Okay, now let's go to combat demonstration, and I think let's set orbit at 20. Okay, setting better setting auto orbit target. Okay, now let's move to the combat demonstration. Okay, where is the beacon? Ah, this is it.
Warp drive active.
Okay, let's do that. Our base speed is 425, and let's take a look after we, wow, after we turn on our micro warp drive, our navigation is goes up to 1933, which is nice. And look at that, look at our damage, and we can barely orbit at 220 kilometers. And our damage is okay. Okay, our damage is 2300. Yes, I think it's very nice. Wow. So the enemy is moving at high speed too. That's why our ship is moving like this. Okay, nice. Okay, let's take a look how much damage we got against. The Frigates. Boom. 2352. So, for cruiser, it's almost near there. And for the frigates, the same. It's very nice, I think. Boom. So frigates just need two damage, I mean to hit to destroy them, which is nice. And you can look at our capacitor. If we are not using any of these models, we are just kept stable, and that's nice. Again, the enemies is moving at high speed, and our ship is keeping the range from our enemies, and that's why we are moving like this, like a worm. Oh, the enemies is getting buffed by the enemies. Okay, what is that buff? But yes, if you look for the performance of this tower assault, this ship is very, very nice. And if you are destroyer lover, I recommend you to using this. The missile damage is good. The micro warp drive signature radius adjustment is awesome. The stasis will be fire. Optimal range is awesome. And the speed is very nice. I think maybe this is the best destroyer for now. Before that, command destroyer is coming. But yes, this ship is very, very nice. And if you can keep your range from your enemies at about 20 kilometers or maybe the max 25 kilometers for our missile range, of course we are untouchable by the enemy's scrambler or the enemy's webby fire, and that's nice. Okay, and that's it. That's the end of this video and the end of combat demonstration for this tower assault. I'm not gonna take your very long time. I hope you enjoy our video, and if you like this video, please press like on our video. And if you want anything to be reviewed, just comment on the comment section. In the next, I think maybe the face tanking with Dominix with shield tanking, and yes, maybe the Balgorn or maybe anything else. Or if you want anything to be reviewed, please tell me on the comment section. Okay, and if you haven't subscribed to my channel, please subscribe to support us. And once again, I'm saying thank you for watching my video, and see you on the next video. Bye bye.